Okay, Michael, so we did supervised learning, and we did unsupervised learning and randomized optimization.
Yep.
And the last section of the course was on reinforcement learning.
Nice.
Now, there's a lot of stuff we didn't cover in that section of the course, which sort of makes me sad because that's what I do for a living. I do reinforcement learning, a little bit of game theory. You do a lot of game theory and a lot of reinforcement learning, and there were a bunch of things that we didn't cover. Can you think of anything in particular you wish you had mentioned?
Well, I think the thing that most people want to know about when they hear about reinforcement learning is function approximation. So the idea of, can you apply this idea to something other than a 3x3 grid world, right? And so to do that, you often have to use the ideas that we talked about in the other sections of the class. So use ideas from supervised learning to learn something about the environment that you are acting in.
Or even things from the unsupervised learning section of the class.
Like feature selection.
And in fact, that general the notion of function approximation is sort of a special case, maybe is the right term, of abstraction, in particular state abstraction, action abstraction, this sort of notion of being able to learn about one part of the space and have it teach you about other parts of the space.
Generalization
in general, yeah. That's a big part of making reinforcement learning work in the real world. Speaking of which, there's PomDPs. We didn't talk about PomDPs
at all. Yeah, I get asked about that a lot. So, should I say what it is?
Just people on the street walk up to you and say, PomDPs, what's that all about?
It's surprising.
I would be surprised. So why don't you explain what PomDPs are in 5 minutes?
Usually it's after class when I'm talking about something else.
Oh, that I believe.
So partially observable Markov decision processes, right? Mm-hmm. So when we talked about without the Po, MDP, So when you talk about MDPs, the agent always has complete information about what the current state is, right? Mm-hmm. That's the state is what you're using to decide what to do. The policy maps state to action. But in reality, you don't really have complete state information. You have to, if you're a helicopter and you're flying through the air, you have to decide what to do based on what you can sense right now. And there may be even uncertainty about what's actually going on around you.
Right.
And so you can't just use state information because you don't have it. So in the PomDP world, there's a separation between what the actual world has as its current state and what the decision maker knows to be its perception of the state. And those can be out of whack.
And that makes sense. I mean, we live in a world where we don't know what is happening in, for every atom in the universe, and it might actually matter. So, you know, there's a whole other class of problems that I wish we could have talked about that we didn't, and those are all the ones that involve humans.
Right?
A lot of game theory is, you know, mathematical and abstract, but really it's about trying to understand human behavior, right? In fact, there's been a bunch of work done on bringing in behavior into game theory and game theory into behavior and marrying economics, game theory, sociology, marketing, and
psychology. Right. Yeah, I mean, behavioral game theory is one of the names for that. Though neuroeconomics also comes up as a word that just seems like it shouldn't be a word.
Yeah, that feels kind of made up.
Yeah. Except I will pay you in brain cells.
I get those brains.
Right, that's the currency that zombies use.
Okay, so there's a lot of that about people in game theory, but even in reinforcement learning, there's been a huge move, actually dating back decades, but really has exploded over the last 4 or 5 years.
Well, in fact, what is the name of the school that you're in at Georgia Tech?
The School of Interactive Computing.
Yeah, that's the interaction turned out to be a really important thing to some people.
Right, so a lot of my work in reinforcement learning, in particular, has been about bringing people into the loop, learning from people, watching what people do in order to do feature selection or state abstraction or just simple learning.
Some of my best friends care about people.
Are you saying I'm your best friend, Michael? Very good. Okay, so there's a whole bunch of stuff there.
I said some of my best friends. Okay. You are some of my best friends.
I am some of your best friends?
I don't know. But okay. The point is that there's this interesting line that happens when you start thinking about how these learning systems are interacting with people, either once they start to behave in the world or just during the learning process itself.
Right. Because in fact, in practice, that's how we teach it. So obviously, we can talk about this forever.
Yeah, Let me just mention one buzzword. So inverse reinforcement learning is one that I particularly like because we talked about reinforcement learning in the class, where you take a reward function and interaction with an environment, and you create behavior. Mm-hmm. And inverse reinforcement learning goes in the other direction. You start from observations of behavior, interacting in an environment that some expert is doing, and you try to guess what the reward function was that expert would have been using.
Or a reward function that's consistent with that behavior.
Exactly, because you can't know really how rewarding is it to, you know, say, get groaned at when you make a pun, but you can tell that it's obviously more rewarding than not.
Right. But, you know, reward function and reward function times 7 is effectively the same thing.
Yeah, because you can scale them and it doesn't change what the behavior looks like. That's right. And so we don't actually, so what we take away from this is some representation of the motivations, desires of the individual who demonstrated the behavior that we can then transfer into new environments and get good behavior out of
it. Yeah, I think it's broader than that. I think it's even broader than that, which is really you can think of this whole reinforcement learning framework as a kind of programming framework. It's sort of software engineering, and where reinforcement signals are the mechanism by which you program the agent in order to get some particular behavior as opposed to simple function calls. And there just seems like there's a whole discussion to have about
I like that topic very much. In fact, I think we should write a grant proposal about that.
Let's write a grant proposal about that, or maybe a paper to AAAI.
Nice.
Yeah, let's do that. So look, I think it's obvious that we can talk about reinforcement learning forever, even though we didn't spend a lot of time on it in the class, because there's all these basic things you really have to get about supervised learning and unsupervised learning.
But how can we get all this information out there?
I can think of one way.
Direct brain interface.
No.
Okay.
I mean, yes, but no.
Okay.
We could do another class.
You mean, like, together?
Yes, we could do a whole class on reinforcement learning, game theory, and explore all these ideas.
But who would even want to come to such a class?
Everyone, because we're going to make it required.
Oh, that's great.
Mm-hmm.
Let's do that.
Let's do that.
Let's make a class on reinforcement learning.
Yes, we can do a nice 3-hour course on reinforcement learning and game theory, and we can come back and do all the same thing. We can use the same editor.
Yeah, though it's very possible that he'll cut this out if we even talk about it.
No, we'll use the same editor. Pushkar will be there. We'll get the band back together.
Get the band back together again. That sounds really fun. And the groupies can be the same.
Yes, we could have exactly the same set. So, you want to do it?
I think I would.
Let's shake on it.
Let's do this thing.
Done.
All right. Well, then see you in the next class.
Yeah, we'll get started next week.